79-year-old Frank Freshwaters first appeared on the Most Wanted list in 1959 after escaping from an Ohio prison while serving time for manslaughter. But Freshwaters was finally tracked down Monday by federal marshals. He had been living in this mobile home in Melbourne, Florida under the name William Cox and immediately admitted that he was Frank Freshwaters when marshals knocked on his door.
And I don't care who you are, but whether you're running for one day, 1 year, or 56 years, you're always looking out, you know, over your shoulder. And I think time just caught up with them. I think there's, believe it or not, I think there's a sense of relief once they're captured because they don't have to look over their shoulder any longer.
Court records indicate that back on July 3rd, 1957, then 21-year-old Frank Freshwaters was driving down South Arlington Street in Akron when he ran over a pedestrian by the name of Eugene Flint. Freshwaters would later plead guilty to a charge of manslaughter. Eugene Flint left behind a young wife and three young sons. His lone surviving son, Richard Flint, was just three when his father was killed and says his family has always harbored hard feelings about the way Frank Freshwaters ran down his father while drunk behind the wheel and then escaped justice for more than a half century.
Yeah, put us in nothing but hardship for most of our lives. Everybody makes mistakes, but everybody has to pay for mistakes. He made it a long time, but as old as it is, I don't think he has a lot of time to pay for it now.
Frank Freshwaters was initially placed on probation for causing the death of Eugene Flint, but was later sent to the infamous Ohio State Reformatory in Mansfield to begin serving a term of 1 to 20 years after he violated the terms of his probation. The prison was the backdrop for the movie The Shawshank Redemption. Freshwaters was able to escape after he was moved to an honor farm to finish his sentence. Over the decades, the U.S. Marshals Service and other law enforcement agencies tried to track him down.
We have a saying in the Marshals Service, let no guilty man escape. We don't like anybody that thinks they're better than us and they're going to get away with things.
The search for Frank Freshwaters heated up when the Marshals Service in Cleveland created a cold case unit to hunt for fugitives who had escaped from Ohio prisons in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. The Marshals Service will not say exactly what led them to Freshwaters because they plan to use the same method to track down other fugitives.
I don't care who you are. You always leave behind clues, and it's our job in law enforcement as an investigator is to put together all those little clues that they're going to make a difference.
Jack Shea, Fox 8 News in Cleveland.